EGOT winner, which, for those of you that don't know, an EGOT is someone who has won an Emmy, a Grammy, an Oscar, and a Tony Award. And Richard Rodgers was the first ever EGOT winner. He also has won a Pulitzer Prize as well, making he and Marvin Hamlisch the only two people ever to achieve winning all of those awards. So we thought he was a pretty important guy and someone that your children should all know about. So you will be seeing songs that have all been written by Richard Rodgers and one of his family members, and with some of his various collaborators. So the first song that we're going to be featuring is our Marine group. They are going to be singing, they're going to be presenting their dance to Getting to Know You from The King and I by Rodgers and Hammerstein. So here they are.
Spat on the subject I like most, getting to know you. Getting to know you, getting to know all about you, getting to like you, getting to hope you love me, getting to know.
Blue moon.
working with your kids all week as well. All right, and coming up next, we have our green group. Our youngest campers are going to come back out on stage, and they are going to do their acting presentation for you. So I'll turn this over to you.
So in our acting class, we talked a lot about how we as actors have two prominent tools that we use, our voices and our bodies. So in this exercise, we have explored creatively how we can use our bodies to become different objects, animals, anything you can think of. So this is just an imagination game that we have been playing throughout the week. Hi guys, you ready? Everyone find their own space on the stage? Good, good. All right, now close your eyes. Everyone close your eyes. All right. Now imagine you're at the ocean. You're on the beach, right?
Right.
How does the sand feel between your toes? Is it really, really hot? Are you running along the sand to try to make your feet stay cool? Do you run into the waves? Is it windy, or are there a lot of waves, or is the water really still? Now you look back at the beach from the waves and you see your family. What are they doing? Are they reading a book? Are they tanning? Are they taking a walk? Do you have any pets that you see on the beach? There's another family that's walking their dogs. Some people are playing volleyball. Think about all the different things you see on the beach. Then look in the water and think about all the different sea creatures that you might see. There's lots of fish. There might be some little crabs. The crabs are completely harmless. You're not afraid of them. Think about everything you see. Look up at the sky. Are there lots of clouds? Or is it really, really clear? All right, now pick your favorite thing that you see on the beach. Anything that you see, okay? Now open your eyes and become that thing.
class, and I'm like, well, I played this game, and I played this game, and I played this game. And you're like, huh, there are so many games. A lot of the times, with teaching younger children, with acting and things like that, really one of the most important things that we want to do at this age, which you as parents, clearly you're sending your kids to camp, you understand this and you appreciate this, is fostering creativity, understanding their creative minds, and allowing them to use them. So we encourage you to, you know, when your kid's rolling around on the floor in a blanket, and you're like, which reminds me a lot, and you wonder, what? And you're like, okay, what are you doing? What are you doing? And they tell you, I'm being a taco, or I'm a dog, and I'm covered under a blanket, and I'm trying to dig my way out. Those are all things that you want to encourage. You want to encourage that creativity and fostering that, because as they grow older, they can use those pretend games that they played and put them on stage. So we love creativity and theater games. All right, and up next we have our Oklahoma medley. So we are going to invite our red group on stage. You'll be seeing some soloists. And here they are. The soloists for our Oklahoma medley are Amanda Brown, Finn Chambers, Keenan Griffith, Jaden Levine, Kate Phillips, Molly Soddy, and Allison Jones. So while the red group is coming out, I'm just going to give you guys a little history on Oklahoma. So red group, come on out and get in places. All right. So Oklahoma was the very first collaboration between Rodgers and Hammerstein. And it really changed the landscape of musical theater. It introduced the golden age of Broadway, which focused and put a focus on the musicals, that put a focus on plot and character development, and things like that that really hadn't happened before in musical theater. So really, musical theater as we know it today, this was one of the first shows to usher that in. And it was also one of the first real Broadway smashes. It ran for over 2,000 performances, so it was the original long-running musical. And so here we have the red group singing an Oklahoma medley. Celebrating on the way out the door. door, there are season brochures. We really hope that you will join us for our next year season and our next main stage season as well. We are really excited about the slate of shows that we have going on, particularly with our youth theater, which includes The Lion King, and James and the Giant Peach, and Arthur's Halloween. And we really hope that we see your children come out and audition and look for those shows. All auditions are always on our website, www.erieplayhouse.org. And you can always contact me. You've all talked to me. I have my email. Shoot me an email, and I can help you out with information. Also, on your way out the door, there are flyers for you. If you are interested in bringing your family to our to shows at the Playhouse, we are offering a special deal for families of campers for season tickets. So for 1 week, you guys can get reduced rates on our family package season tickets. So make sure to grab a brochure on the brochure and flyer on the way out. And again, if you have any questions, you can always contact me or contact our box office. And thank you very much. And I will now turn this over to Dom, wherever he is.
There he is.
Oh, there he is. For the Blue Group's acting presentation. And while I'm standing here, they're both here, I'll introduce to you our acting instructors. We have Jenna Sumucki and Dominic Del Greco, who have been teaching acting.
All right, so one of the things that we like to focus on when we teach acting, Kate already told you all about, you know, fostering creativity and everything like that, and I think one of the most brilliant ways to do that is with improvisational theater. I think that it really kind of fosters a creative spirit, and so we focus a little bit on that, and this is my favorite improv game. It's called Jack and Jill. And the point of it is there will be a number of children sitting in front of you. It varies from group to group. And we will take suggestions from the audience as to where they are and what they're talking about. And sometime in the conversation, they are either going to bring up their friend Jack or their friend Jill, in this case. And each one of your kids will say one thing about Jack and or Jill, whether it is a way that they talk, a way that they walk, a way they hold themselves, something they always do, anything like that. And then, out of nowhere, wouldn't you know it, Jill is going to show up, and she has to inhabit all of the qualities that her friends have given to her at random, and it's beautiful. We end up with some really funny situations. So, all right, then I will let you guys say, oh no, wait, we need a place. Yeah, so where are they? Where are they? Anywhere at all, and I'm going to take it from the audience. Yeah, go ahead, just shout it. Starbucks, you're at Starbucks, because why not? And what are they talking about at Starbucks? This place is crazy.
Weather.
Boys. Talking about boys. Okay. and you are discussing Cheerios. Perhaps flavors. I don't know. All right, take it away. Let's see what happens.
One.
Me too.
That's what reminds me of Sometimes you see for 10 seconds, it flies like a bird.
Thank you.
Anyone? Bueller?
Yeah.
try to deal with the bear and it totally doesn't work. But it turns out to be a pretty bad idea. And how do they solve the problem?
Act like bear.
They what?
Act like bear.
They teach everyone to make bear claws. This is beautiful. All right. Cool. This is a very uplifting story now. Yeah. All right. So let's see. It's chefs making buckets, but bears. Okay. Ballerinas and one jelly beans. Why can't they have jelly beans?
Because the jaw.
Mr. Cow says no. Yeah, I don't know. I like this. All right. See what happens. What do they do to try to get these jelly beans from Mr. Cow? Already have elements.
As you know, the Playhouse is a volunteer-based organization, and we cannot do anything without the volunteers that support us. And that goes for youth theater, that goes for main stage, that goes for our day-to-day operations. And we value their contributions so, 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 so strongly. And I'd like to invite our counselors out on stage to thank them for all the work that they do. So we had Katie Berlin, where she is, Dave Burns, and Dave Bastion, you know, that's why they call her Life Board as well. We have Jenna Hallis, Greg McKay, Troy Kosecki, Karen Evening, Rebecca Rowinski, and Melina Walter. And truly, you know, I couldn't be everywhere all at once, and without these exceptional young ladies, camp would not be able to run. They are the ones that day-to-day make sure that your children, you know, if somebody had if somebody had to go to the bathroom, if somebody had to drink water, if somebody just needed a hug, they were there for your children every day, and without them, we would not be able to do what we do. So I thank them all so very much. They're wonderful guests. Continue to help you give that gift to them. So I thank you, and I pray your children will feel never walk alone.